So yes, sir. Yes, sir. This is episode 23 of the Bars on Deck podcast.
Yeah.
You got your boy King Swift, the host. We got Tiki motherfucking Boom Boom in the building. Tiki, how?
Yo,
good,
yo.
My nigga. How you
I'm feeling?
Feeling
good, man. The energy is right, man.
Right.
Everything is beautiful. 2023, we made it.
Yes, sir. We made it. You know what I mean? I've been seeing you for a while. We've been trying to do this for a little fucking minute.
That's a fact.
But you know, you've always been my nigga. You like my brother. You know what I mean? And we finally here. You know what I mean? It's no better time than the fucking present, man.
The time is now, man.
Tell me what's some of the things you got on the agenda right now. What you got going on, man?
I've been low key for a minute, but the agenda is definitely ticking and booming once again. We in year 2023.
Right.
I've been working on some sauce. You know what I'm saying? I be doing a little cooking. I was working on some sauce and shit, but I definitely been working on some music. I dropped some couple of freestyles last year. You know what I'm saying? It's on my Instagram page and shit.
Oh yeah, so
I
gotta follow at Tiki Boom Boom.
Yes sir, Tiki Boom Boom, TikeyBoomBoom.
Yes sir.
You know what I'm saying? You may have to scroll a few back, but I got some freestyles.
I'm gonna put it in there when I edit, so they're gonna see what it is.
I definitely got some current freestyles in there, you know, some covers, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I had to get back in the booth, test run my shit,
okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay, that's what it is. So when you do the freestyle thing, I know you a nigga around my age, but we the same age. So you boom bap or you drill rap? What's your preferred style, or do you stay current with the time?
I don't even know if I got a style, bro. I know I go off the energy. I go off the energy of the music. I definitely don't get some gas, bro.
Right.
some gas.
Yes, sir.
I go off the energy. I don't do no drill. I don't want to say I don't do drill. I can get on anything. I say that.
Okay.
My versatility could put me in places where I didn't think I could be,
right,
and places I can go. That's the best place. That's the best way I can say that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I dig that. Because a lot of motherfuckers, they today you hear drill, niggas do a whole album worth of drill, but they got bars though, but not when they do drill. Because drill, right, like when you don't know how to ride the beat, the drill beat,
right,
it's kind of tough. So when it seemed like to me a lot of niggas be forcing it. Like some niggas got it, like Ice Spice, she kind of
right
with it.
Right.
She still need a little work.
Right.
But it's a lot of niggas that I hear, they forcing their lyrics, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I don't really recommend that a nigga do it, but they like it. The sound is different, you know
right
what I mean?
For me, if I was doing some drill shit, I may not even know it's a drill beat. I'm just going to get on shit I like and just flow how I flow to it. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? I go off the energy of the beat. You know what I'm saying? Maybe if I say I gotta go, say I'm in a studio with niggas and I'm on a nigga feature or something like that. Excuse me, pardon me. I'm on a feature or something. And if I go first or we just spin verses. If I understand the drill rap, then I could go on that type of flow with it. But if we go in and a nigga say, yo, listen, I got the beat, come to the studio, and you go in and I never heard these niggas verses, I'm gonna just spit how I feel to the beat.
Type shit.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not, if they say it's drill, it's so many genres of topics of drill, this, that, boom,
yeah,
bap.
Yeah,
I just go off. That shit fire to me, I'm giving it the energy I'm gonna bring to it.
Okay, so
you know what I'm saying?
Is it always gonna be, because we New York niggas, you know what I mean? Is it gonna be New York, or is it gonna be something that niggas outside of New York kind of comprehend and understand too?
I would say, again, being versatile, I would say depends on what the, again, it's gonna be off the vibe of what the record's about. You know what I'm saying? I could go south, slow it down, or kind of just be on some chill bop, whatever. Or I could keep it on some New York shit if it's a New York drill rapper, and we gonna keep it on New York type
stuff.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? We gonna, you know what I'm saying? You see the army fatigue kind of flow, you know?
Nah, yeah, that's fine.
I get into it, New York style, you heard?
Yeah, you got to, man. You got to, because New York is the, you know, the home of hip hop. You know what
that's
I mean?
A
we
fact.
Started
we
this
originated
shit.
It.
Right. You know what I'm saying? And people have made it better, made it different.
That's
but
a fact.
It's always going to be how we created it. You know what I'm saying?
That's
it's never going to change into nothing else. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
But I just be wanting to know, like, pick niggas' brain on how niggas get into their shit. You know what I'm saying? And how they do what they do. And, you know, you've been rapping for how long now?
Bro, I've been rapping 100% since 2014.
Oh, so like that serious? Or
dead
like,
serious. Since okay. That's when I put the first mixtape out.
Mm.
I put my first mixtape out.
What was that shit called?
Money Talk Silent Pays.
Okay.
Money Talk Silent Pays. It still might be on SoundCloud. I got some tracks on YouTube. I got two singles on motherfucking iTunes. I got a station on Pandora.
You know what I'm saying? Working, nigga.
Oh, I was working, bro. I was definitely working, B. I was definitely working. You know what I'm saying?
I can dig that.
You know what I'm saying? I was definitely outside, man. Yeah, independent. My own pockets, obviously.
You and the team and all of that.
That's a fact. Shout out to SMG, my man Stable, Big States, Primo, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I was, you know, I've been following you since forever. And I seen y'all niggas traveling at one point. Niggas was all like fake on tour and shit.
Nigga, we was really on tour. It was
nothing fake. There was nothing fake about it, nigga.
Hey, we went to Baltimore. My nigga, we went to Baltimore. We performed in Baltimore. Not no short 15-minute sets, nigga. We was doing 30-minute sets. You know what I'm saying?
That was headline. Well, headlining, basically.
Wherever we went, we put a print on it. We went to Baltimore. We did Miami. We went to Atlanta.
Road trip to Atlanta.
We shout out to Atlanta on the Grind Media. We went to Vegas. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my man Dreadbang. You know what I'm saying? They out there in Vegas. So we was around.
We definitely
did our own set. Mercury Lounge, New York City.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I had a 30-minute set. My man stayed. We had an hour set.
Right, you know what I'm saying?
We was working. We had live band. We was here. That was definitely an experience. We a little seasoned on our own shit, bro. You know what I'm saying?
So are you ready to take it to the next level, or are you trying to just stay local? Because some niggas prefer, like, because the internet really helping niggas blow up. So you
That's
really don't need no real exposure. You can just
That's
stay local. You trying to stay there, or you trying to, like, go major?
I'm going to keep it a toe stack. Right now, I just want motherfuckers just to get back in tune with the music
that
I put out. And I'm gonna let the people, I know what I'm gonna go with it. You know what I'm saying? Right now I'm independent, still independent. You know what I'm saying? But I got, when the bag come and it's the right time, we gonna go from there. You know what I'm saying? Other than that, I've been doing pretty good how I've been moving. You know what I'm saying? I'm not hurting. You know what I'm saying?
I've been rocking.
And when the people feel the music, when I start putting new music out, people fuck with the music I come back into, and the streams and the downloads and shit start coming, then we're gonna keep it pushing where it's supposed to go. You know what I'm saying? But we always ticking and booming. We always gonna keep it ticking and booming, that's for sure.
Yeah, that's a fact. That's a fact. You know, because I just like when niggas be like working, stay productive. Like, you know what I mean? I don't want you to burn yourself out, but always stay busy. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
Like, have something going on. Like, we old the niggas now. Stop the street shit so much and start getting to something. You know what I mean? I don't care if niggas do the street shit at the studio. Fuck it.
That's a fact.
But get out of the streets, you know what I mean?
I was gonna say, it's funny you say that, right? Because it was a little minute before I got back in the studio. And the unfortunate passing of my pops put me back in the studio. Appreciate it, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. So what got me back in the studio, I was behind the scenes, because for a minute when I wasn't recording and I wasn't performing, I was hosting. With my man Hunter.
Get into that.
That's a fact. Shout out to my man Hunter Carrots, Hottest in the City Showcases. You know what I'm saying? I was always busy.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
So when I stepped away from me actually recording and performing, I was hosting. And when I took a time off that, I was just getting things right behind the scenes, you know what I'm saying? Getting shit together.
Right.
And unfortunately, my pops passed away. And it just felt right that I did a song with my brothers. It's the first time I went back in the studio. And the joint just felt good. And I was in the studio every month after that.
You know what I'm saying?
Like for the next 6 months, I was doing covers with my niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And that got me back in the studio, right?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So it was like, the untimely death was like one thing, but it was kind of like necessary because it gave you the time to break. You needed to get right back into that.
That's a fact. You had that energy,
you know what I'm saying?
That's a fact. I had something to talk about. You know what I'm saying? Right. I had some music with substance to it.
I was about to say that, right?
It felt right. You know what I'm saying? And I gave it what I needed to give it. And the reception of that was good. You know what I'm saying? Even though, because it wasn't just about my pops. It was just for anybody who lost somebody. And it was a good record. You know what I'm saying? It's a good record. You know what I mean? Real shit. I can dig that.
So I'm going to wait till we get to the next set to ask you about the hosting thing. But when it comes to your music style and your writing, right? Do you write, pre-write, or do you write in the studio?
Depends. I pre-write. If a nigga invite me to the studio on the humble and I ain't get a chance to hear the beat and he got block time or whatever have you and we working on this one record, I'll write the shit right there too. You know what I'm saying?
Type shit.
I write because, again, it goes off the... If I get invited to the studio by an artist, you know, this probably happens many times. I don't give too many advice, but if I've been invited to a studio with an artist and if I haven't heard the record and they got the block time off or whatever, they made a slot time for us to work on the record, then I'm working on the record right then and there. I'm giving you fresh
energy
right there.
The studio
that's
time
a fact.
Book. Right.
That's
might
a fact.
As well, yeah.
I'm giving you the fresh energy right there. You know what I'm saying?
Because I see when I used to like doing that, like writing on the spot, because I used to like keeping my 16s for me. Like
okay.
Pre-written.
That's a fact. That's a fact.
Those is like sentimental.
That's
like,
a fact.
You know what I mean? So I wanted to keep my work separate. Unless I had like a 16 that I could throw away.
That's a fact.
Then fuck it. I got something to that. Yeah. I like that beat. Yeah. Something go perfect with that.
I was
JV in it. Yeah, I smoked.
My bad, bro. I got you the next one I roll up.
What happened was, right, my breathing got fucked up like 2 weeks ago, so I've been on like a 2 week break. But my man came in here early. I did some shirts for him because I be pressing the shirts and shit.
We gonna talk.
Yeah, I be doing all of the merch I got and all of that.
We gonna talk.
Right, so
I need a nigga like you. We gonna talk more.
Right. So he came and he picked up. I gave him like 2 dozen tees, and that nigga passed me the joint. And you know, when you're a smoker, even though you're telling yourself you're not smoking,
right.
I took the shit.
Right.
And I took 2 pulls. I'm like, oh shit, I ain't
getting contact like a motherfucker right now.
Nigga, I'm feeling fake nice, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, the next one we can smoke, cause it's been like 2 weeks, so
you can talk one time, you can hit the side. That's all you need. You may only need 2 hits of this shit.
Yeah, yeah. Shit, I can hit it a couple times, but I know I'm gonna be high as fuck, but
we gonna get it.
Yeah, that's a fact. But
we ain't gonna lose flow. We here.
Yeah, we here. We ain't gonna go off topic. You know me. I've been doing this so long, bro. Like, it's like, cause how I got into this shit is crazy, right? Like, I was in school back in 2015. I decided to go to school out of nowhere. Cause I didn't know what to do with my life. Like,
okay.
You know what I'm saying? I was tired of doing the nickel and dime shit, running around here. So I'm like,
no purpose.
It's either go back to work or go back to school.
Right.
So I'm like, all right, so when I went back to school, I said, all right, boom. What am I gonna do? I wanted to do something revolving around music. So I'm like, do I do something revolving around music or do I do something just whatever? And then I went to TCI and they had no music program there.
Okay.
But the nigga had already reeled me in, so I'm like, fuck, I'm already in this shit.
Right.
So I did digital media arts.
Okay.
Right, so I got into that, and then I took a course on the side where I had to, it was like a speech class, right?
Okay.
And
communications and shit.
Communications, right. And then at the end of it, I had to interview a nigga. I had 3 options. I had to either interview a nigga, make a collage, do some shit. So I didn't want to do all that extra shit.
Okay.
So I interviewed somebody. I interviewed one of my teachers, and I'm like, yo, I got an A. And she was like, nah, you did a good interview. And that shit woke me up. The following 2 summers, because I started in 2018. The following 2 summers, I worked on perfecting that shit, getting better.
Okay.
Working about how I speak, because I ain't like how I speak.
Right. Take some use to it.
Yeah. I ain't like how I looked on camera. None of that, right? So it took me a little minute to figure out my groove. And then I got here. And I was like, nah. Because I already knew how to do the interview.
Right.
But it's all about making sure you stay consistent with your conversation and all
that
shit.
It's a fact.
And I'm like, nah, I gotta work on that. My wifey was telling me too, like, yo, it's just gonna sound repetitive. Like, you gotta
work on the questions.
Yeah, you gotta work on your questions. You gotta know who you're talking to.
And then you gotta do your research.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, see, somebody like we like family. So, you know what I mean? By now, my shit's just come off the top. Like,
it's natural.
Right. As we speaking, my brain is like, nah, yo, this question next and this question next.
Computing.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So I'm just on it now. You know what I mean? And
fact.
I knew that from that day when my teacher told me that you got something here, I knew to take it somewhere.
That's a fact.
Then the podcast shit was popping. Podcast was popping. 2015, niggas had podcasts.
I've been wanting to do a podcast too.
Yeah.
I got some ideas for a podcast, bro. I've been thinking about it for the last 2 years. I got some dope ideas. I helped my man's work on his podcast when it first jumped off. Shout out to Big Picture Podcast. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you fuck with Big Picture?
Yeah, fuck my man.
My man was it's funny. My man was on there. I used to go to his events. You know a nigga named Will?
I know Will.
Have you met Will?
I've met him.
Yeah.
I've met him.
I used to go to his events. Yeah. It's crazy because my shorty, back when they was in school,
shout
that was
out to
his
Big
girl.
Cravens.
Right.
Come on now.
Phil Flames.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know if you know Phil Flames.
I don't think I met Phil Flames. Okay, I don't
He's
think I met
Queens.
Him.
He's from Queens. He dope. Phil is dope, but he a backpack rapper. He like a fun rapper. Like, he talk about his ride on the train.
type shit.
You know what I'm saying? And that shit be fire though.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like he'll bring anime shit into that
That's
shit.
That's how I see that nigga nice like yeah, that. You know what I like saying? That.
Right.
May have to meet that nigga, man.
Yeah, if you fuck with Will, then he'll definitely, cause they like brothers. They you know what I'm saying, they're inseparable.
Okay.
But yeah, you know what I mean? I used to go to Will talent. He used to do like host like little talent shows and shit in his club in Brooklyn. And I went in there twice, burnt it down, took my cousin from France.
Okay.
So, you know that nigga all French. I'm half French and shit, so
okay.
That nigga was, he don't speak no English.
So said no patouche, man.
Yeah, no patouche. No patouche. You know what I'm saying? So.
I know, son, nigga. Tiki Boo, man. What the fuck did you talking about? Sock Box said?
My boulet.
Vagabond.
Oh, shit. So you already know. So yeah, that's how it was, right?
Tiki Boo, man.
So my cousin, right, he sends me this beat, right?
I'm listening.
And he says, yo, I got the song done. It's called Get This Money.
Okay.
Right? But in French, it's called Fesula.
Fesula.
Right? So he said, yo, I want you to do an English version of this shit. I went to Phil Flames in Queens.
Okay.
I did the shit. I sent it back to my cousin. That nigga was in love with the shit. That nigga was like, yo, I'm coming to New York. You got to do some shows. So okay. Phil Flames and Will, they had the shows.
Okay.
So we get out there, boom, we do the shows. Everybody love it. Big nigga talking about this shit. I got the Lennon shit on. I'm out there fly. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
yeah, yeah. You know.
We do what we do.
We got to show up and show out, my
and
nigga.
And that shit was a success. But then I was like, nah, I don't really want to do music no more. But that shit was fire, though.
Right.
So I tried to get into management and all that shit, but it didn't really work out.
Motherfuckers told me I should do some management.
I tried, but it's you dealing with niggas, bro. I'm
dealing with people lives.
Yeah, yo.
And you like, gotta deal with everything that come with it.
Yeah, like, and niggas is not ready, bro. Like, niggas is not ready.
Patience.
Like, I'm the type of nigga, I'm on go. So if I manage you, I'm gonna be like, yo, Tick, how many freestyles you wrote this week? How many songs you wrote this week?
Right.
If you say one or two,
right.
All right, we can work with that, but I'm expecting you, if, at the level you at, to be at five and six.
Facts. You should be putting in this work.
You should be putting, because now we could get the YouTube channel popping, we can get the Spotify.
Type shit.
You know what I'm saying? And we don't need no label yet. And then now we can increase the value.
That's offending when you go have that conversation.
Right, because I already got connects. I already know niggas that sway in the morning. So I can get you on the radio, you know what I'm saying? That ain't nothing. But I'm not trying to deal with these knucklehead niggas, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't want to get into it. So podcasts that work for me. So now my next question to you is, because your lane is still rap, my lane is podcasting. Even though if you say, yo, Swift, get on this song with me. Oh, I'm going to get on the song with you. But my next question to you, since you jumped out of rap a little bit.
Right.
How did you get into that hosting shit? I saw that on your IG and I was like, nah, this nigga's going to something. How did you get into that? Being that we was talking about Will and shit and all of that. From Big Picture and all that.
The hosting came about on some... shout out to my man Stable. You know me on the mic. I could get on the mic anywhere at any time and do what I need to do. Put me in a fucking arena in Madison Square Garden, nigga.
You gonna burn that bitch down.
You could put me in a club in a hole in the wall neighborhood in a bar.
Yeah.
I'm going to burn it. So
right.
For me to being able to communicate and take to be an MC to control a crowd, that's just what I was doing before. When I would start my performance, I would say a few words, you know what I'm saying? You know how motherfuckers like to talk shit before you perform, DJ, that. So that shit became normal to me. You know what I'm saying? So for me to be able to articulate and just be able to grab the mic, pause, and just flow how I flow, it just was like, you know what, my man Stable, shout out to Stable, SMG, he recommended me, like, yo, my man Honey, he got this thing going on.
He could
use a co-host.
That's Honey Carrot,
right? My man, Honey Carrot.
Right.
Shout out to Hottest in the City.
You're right.
He was like, yo, you'd be a good fit. Me and my man, Honey Link. I was like, yo, my nigga. This how it really was. I was like, you know what? Test run it, bro. Let me just test run it.
See what it's about.
I don't want no bread. You ain't got to break no bread with me, bro. Just let me know what's going on because I'm working on, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
Getting my shit together.
Yeah.
Say less. Did a few shows. Shit was just clicking, bro. Shit was just clicking. The shows, people coming to the shows. Shit was natural for me. And then eventually we started getting to the bag. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, so not a month. That's you know the blessing. See, real niggas like you come a dime a dozen. You don't take the upfront money because the back end money is better.
That's a fact.
And then you built up your name and
that's
then
a fact.
The whole shit got value. Now that's it's like,
fact.
All right, come in. You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
And that's smarter.
That's a fact because motherfuckers don't give you. I mean, I came from. My shit is. If it makes sense, let's make it make sense, B. Yeah. I want to make money. Yeah, we want to get to the bag, but I don't, like you said, I don't know if your shit has value. I don't know if I bring value to your shit.
Right.
But we gonna work it out and see what's what. And then once we see that we got the chemistry, then now we break bread, and we definitely broke bread. You know what I'm saying?
That's how you gotta do it, man.
Shout out to 100 Carats, my nigga. That's my man right now. Still cool as a motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? And we've done a lot of motherfucking showcases. Shout out to everybody who pulled up to the showcases because they know what it is. They know what it is, man.
That's a
fact. They know what it is. Hottest in the city was the hottest in the city. There was no way niggas wanted to go but to the hottest in the city, man. So many artists pulled up. I mean, shout out to Styles P, pulled up. Also, on the humble, behind her. No, nobody performed. This is people that's pulled up.
Because they recognize.
Because, matter of fact, Styles P did perform at one segment. He did perform. Shout out to Uncle Myrtle, who pulled up one time. You know what I'm saying? Shout out
GMG
to
GMG in the building.
GMG. Shout out to Fetty Wap. He pulled up on the humble way before early. Like, motherfuckers was popping out, man. There's a lot of artists that popped out, too, yo.
Oh, nah, man. So, y'all was outside. Y'all was doing what y'all had to do. And that's what I'm saying, like that shit, opportunities like that don't come, so you gotta seize that moment.
You gotta take control of your moment, my nigga. Yo, take your moment, bro.
Yeah, that's a thing.
And I learned that early, my nigga. Like, I learned that, like, how many times has a nigga say, yo, I could have bagged this bitch? I seen I could have bagged the nigga, wait, bag it. How many times you might have seen somebody back in the day when it was cool to take pictures?
Yeah, right.
And be like, when it was cool to take pictures, now it'd be like, I still take pictures of motherfuckers because it's still cool to me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not changing who I am. Niggas be wild, but it depends on what the setting is. You know what I'm saying? I'm not running down on niggas to run and take pictures. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But if I've seen plenty of niggas in the street and the setting was right and it's cool to take pictures. I'm not going out my way, but I say that to say that at one point, nigga, it when it's mutual and it's genuine, shit just happened like it's supposed to happen, bro.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And things and fruition comes into to those things. You know what I mean?
Right. Just happen. Like me and you, Lincoln. Now we, like that's I said, fact. I've been trying to get you on for 2 years, but the timing wasn't right.
We was bumping into each other. I don't know how many times in the street. You know what I'm saying? Just
mad
on the
times,
humble.
Nigga.
Nigga, we got booked together. You know what I'm saying?
We're going to get into that in a minute. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Niggas got booked back like 10 years ago.
So it's the chemistry, and this is why, man, you got to watch, first off, your persons. You got to, no negativity, man, because you never know who you're going to run. It's a small world. As big as this world is, it's a small world, as they say, my nigga. You never know who you're going to run into at any given time or place, bro.
Right, and what they doing.
And what they doing, man. So if you on the type of time that you on with shit, aligning with what you do, then you're gonna realign with the motherfuckers you're supposed to be around.
That's a fact, bro.
That's
a big fact. So being that you brought that up, how we link and we got booked, let's get into that, right? Because I'm not a hardcore street nigga, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But I did some things back in my day, you know what I'm saying? And I'm proud of the moves I made because I'm not gonna say I'm not proud. It wasn't like I was doing anything heinous, you know what I mean? Niggas was just doing street shit to make a little side hustle. Mm-hmm. Well, how we met, I was just telling you off camera, and you was like, yo, refresh my memory, right? So for everybody viewing, how me and Tiki Boom met, Tiki didn't remember this, y'all.
Yeah, he had to bring this shit up.
Bring this shit up, and I was waiting to say this because it's gonna come full circle because we met our bigger homie, Jeff.
That's a fact.
Right?
Shout out to Jeff,
man. Boss Department Jeff. That's what we call him. That's the gas king,
most
right?
Of y'all niggas from Harlem, what, 20 years ago? Not even, I'm lying. 10 plus, maybe 15 plus. If you know, Jeff had the gas, nigga.
Get it, ass, nigga.
Gas. Come on, my nigga. It was plenty of motherfuckers that was upstairs.
Right, when Jeff had the gas,
nigga. Right. Stop it, the sour, nigga.
Nah,
yeah, sour.
That nigga had some shit, I forgot what it was called. It was some shit he called me, he said, yo, come to the crib, yo, come smoke something.
Jeff had the sour, my nigga. Sticky, your hands be like this.
Like, niggas don't even got sour. Niggas will say it's sour, but niggas don't got no real sour no more. Like, niggas don't even know what sour is.
The sour, my nigga, let me tell you something back then, because niggas just started buying Ace. Niggas just started buying apes like that. I ain't gonna hold you. Maybe about 10 years ago. Niggas just started buying apes. Because I'm from a dime and dub era.
Yeah, that's how I started, bro.
Nickels, dimes, and dubs. We ain't even know about it. Bro, buying apes.
I ain't even had dubs. I just had dimes and
I was dime and dub. Shout out to 9-9. You know what I'm saying? All my Harlem niggas. Shout out to 9-9.
Anybody from Harlem, you know 9-9, my nigga.
Shout out to 9-9. I never had, I smoked Branson. I never knew where the Branson spot was at. I'm not going to be in here.
I knew where Branson was.
I knew it was somewhere on the round, maybe Edgecombe or some shit like that.
It's in between Frederick and Bradhurst, Edgecombe, that area.
I was around there.
I'm not going to tell them niggas where they at.
And now we're going to keep, even to the day, we're going to keep it like that because that shit was always a mystery. If you knew, you knew.
Because you heard Kiss saying Jaws of Branson.
Come on, man.
In Branson, 24 hours to live. You know what I mean?
Bro, come on, bro. Chocolate.
And they had the Jaws exclusive like how they got now before it was even popular, my nigga. Like, the Jaws was litty, and they would give you a
full brand. They had the Jaws that come with the fucking hair grease that you get out the fucking wave shit right now, nigga.
The glass
Jaws.
That's a Fendi, my nigga.
The glass Jaws that look like if you had hair grease, that it was, I don't know, we had quarters, and you probably, not, maybe,
you could put a 7 in there.
You could put a 7. You might get
14, maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah,
because you gotta remember back in the day, that shit, the chocolate was compressed, bro.
Elliot,
come on. So I had Elliot. I smoked.
I had Elliot too.
Come on,
come on, son. I'm taking you back down memory lane, my
come
nigga.
Come on, son. It was spots on 2/5. You had the radio spot on the record shop on, not the radio, the record shop on 2/5.
Which one? Way up on
right on 5th. 2/5. You go to the back.
Yeah.
I think it's like a chicken spot now.
To get the Sycamore CD.
It might be, that's a fact. That shit might be a chicken spot right now.
I think it is a chicken spot right now.
Come on, my nigga. Come on, my nigga.
It was an African spot after the fucking what's the name?
Come on, yeah. I've been smoking bud for a minute. So these niggas meant back when Arizona had the seeds in it, but it still was looking bright. Green Mango Pina. All that shit was like the first of the exotic because we wasn't even calling it gas. We was calling it exotic.
We were smoking Reggie like it was because it was something back
Reggie,
then.
You know why? Because the Reggie was pure, nigga. The Reggie was sticky.
Yeah.
You could still, Reggie was so good. This is crazy. This is how ill that shit is, right? This is how far back we going. We telling our age like a motherfucker. Reggie was so good though, but Reggie, we going real as real. Reggie was so good when you took all the seeds and the stems out, the shit was still sticky and it still smoked good in the
Dutch. That's a fact. That's a fact.
In the Dutch.
And niggas wasn't ashamed. Like, if I was
not at all.
Yo, this a Reggie blunt, you'd be like, Ari? They'd be like, yeah. Oh, I didn't see that.
Oh, nigga.
And niggas would take that blunt. But nowadays, I'm giving you dirt.
That's so how beef and broccoli became.
That's a fact.
Beef and broccoli. Come on, my nigga.
I used to mix the Elliot with the Ari.
And you had the Haze. Then the Haze came on the scene.
Yep.
Hydro.
Yep.
Hydro.
That was the first sour.
Haze. Sour. Now, that's what I was saying. That's what I'm jumping back on. Niggas had the sour. Jeff had the sour. If you had a dime, I remember seeing one of my mans in Popeyes on 4/5.
Type shit.
Popeyes was just there. Niggas know from Harlem. Remember Popeyes on 4/5 and 8th.
And 8th. Yeah, we ain't gonna call it Freddy. 8th ass.
4/5 and 8th.
Popeyes. Right on the corner.
Popeyes was the shit after Rucker. You walk your ass down to Popeyes, 4/5 and 8th. That was the next scene to be.
Right across from the Jimbo's.
And then when you leave 4/5 and 8th, you might have took it to Lenox.
Yeah, you went down to
Lenox. If you fuck with certain niggas,
was you go to, because that's where the KFC is.
Come on, my nigga. I was all over all of them. If you wanted to go to Lenox, you kept it going. You might have walked to 2/5, walked past 40th, 39th.
Yep.
You had so 42nd. Shout out. It was so many.
It's crazy.
Come on, bro.
But anywho, let's get back to the story, right?
So we're gonna come
full circle to Jeff, right?
Jeff had the sour, before I lose it, Jeff had the diamond sour that, my mans had a diamond sour, smelled up the whole fucking Popeyes, bro. I mean, it smelled like the nigga had a pound
on it.
He
didn't even light it. It was in a bag.
It was in a Ziploc clear bag when we used to do the Ziploc clear bags.
He
had a dime, and that dime smelled the entire Popeyes out. That's real sour.
Nigga had the 125/10
joint. That was real sour.
Dime cleared
your whole fucking... That's real sour.
Yeah. They don't have that no more.
They ain't got that no more.
Nah.
That was a sour that was loud. That's when we started calling it loud.
Yeah. You get on the train, nigga.
It was loud.
Who got it, yo?
And who got it?
Right.
You might have had a dub of that shit. It could have been stuffed in your sockets. Niggas just thought, if you had stop and frisk.
Yeah.
It might have been in your sock, nigga.
Yeah.
And it was pumping.
I was goofing my shit, but still, it's still pumping.
She was loud.
Yeah.
But we gonna keep it pushed. I just had to shout out to Jeff, man. Yeah,
shouts out to Jeff.
Shout
man.
Out to Jeff, Westside Jeff,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, Westside Jeff, Parks Department Jeff.
Parks Department. I met the nigga in the Parks Department.
Yeah, that's the story gonna get there. So boom, yeah, check man. It, right? So you come to the hood, you with your little man, you like, yo, where the weed at? At the time I was doing dumb shit, I ain't had no bud. So you went across the, I said, yo, go over there, my man. Spanish niggas got the weed over there. You go over there, you get the weed. You come back, you like, yo, be careful, my nigga. They booking niggas over there. I'm like, all right, good looking, my nigga. You spin off. Boom, you out of here.
I might have been with my nigga Ken.
You might have been. He was a little smaller than you, but he was a
light skin.
Nah, brown skin. Nigga.
Okay.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna shout out to many niggas names, yeah. But yeah.
So you spin off with that nigga, and then they booked me like an hour later, right? They booked me and my man. On a direct sale. They saw me get this nigga the shit and everything.
Right.
But they didn't see where I put the money.
Right.
So they just got the bud. So boom, we go. I get in the holding cell at PSA 5. And you in the shit next door. We go downtown together and then we get community service. That's how I met Jeff, because I took the community service out. My man was like, nah, you should have just bought it. I'm like, nah, nigga, I'm not trying to have no fuck out of here.
For all y'all niggas that's watching, the younger niggas that's 30 and under, that's when the D's really was stopping and frisking niggas, jumping out on niggas, really jumping out. The D's. That's why shout out to y'all young niggas right now. I fuck with y'all young niggas, but y'all niggas got it good for y'all niggas to be able to move. Some of y'all niggas is disciplined, some of y'all niggas be wild. But shout out to the niggas that's 30 and under. Y'all got it good because niggas that's 30 and over, the D's was jumping out on niggas really.
You knew when that door slammed a certain way, niggas was coming.
Come on, my nigga, the D's. We really had contact with the D's.
Yeah.
On some, it was a war with these niggas. Like these niggas was jumping out on niggas. Yeah. And I'm talking about on some regular weed shit. Fuck what niggas was really getting to.
Right.
We ain't gonna talk about what the niggas was really getting to, how the niggas
we just talking about weed.
We talking about weed, how the D's was doing. The D's would be out lurking for niggas, man.
Nah, they was.
Spotlight lurking for niggas on some prowl and
like
shit.
You said, today is a different day. We could go in a corner store and get the weed now.
Y'all niggas could walk around with the zips on all day and it's regular now, my nigga. To have a dime on you was risky.
Yeah.
It's risky, nigga. You ain't know if you was making it home for a dime or a dub.
That is.
It was risky, my nigga.
It was.
So that was just that. That is a shout out.
So boom, I do the community service. I meet Jeff, right? My homegirl working there from this building. I ain't gonna put a name out there, but my homegirl working there. So I see this big butt joint. So
it's always a big booty.
It's always a big. These bitches was fucking PA. You know what PA is? The welfare shit, right?
That's a fact.
So they was working 9 months. Yeah, public assistance, right? So she bagged a nigga. Jeff come to me immediately, like, yo, she a scally, my nigga, like she a scally, like you fuck with
light
her.
Light work.
You know what I'm saying? You gonna definitely kill her. She had the wide body, my nigga, like.
Ow.
So that's when Jeff was like, yo, be careful, because she take niggas down, like my nigga, like
oh,
you
whoa,
know what I'm talking about, right?
Whoa, I think I know, whoa,
you know
light skin, whoa, Spanish joint, whoa,
Now, Spanish joint wasn't feeling nobody.
The light skin, I think I remember you talking
she
about.
She wasn't feeling nobody. It was a chick named Jasmine.
But I think I know what you're talking about. I ain't killed.
You ain't kill nobody. I killed. I wanted the Spanish joint you're talking about. The Spanish joint you're talking about.
That nigga was looking like Iceberg Slim up there.
That facts. But this nigga was, he knew all of the shit. Like he would take me under the wing. We smoking bud. I'm doing fucking community service, and this nigga's like, yo, huh, smoke.
That's how you met niggas met the plug doing community service, my nigga.
Right.
I don't even look at it like that. Niggas met the plug.
Right.
Doing community service, bro. But that's how it be.
Mm-hmm.
So that's how it be. Niggas on the humble. And once that was there, he told me. I think that day he told me. He's, you know what I'm saying? And then I went to go see the nigga. Then come to find out, I was like, you know how it be? It was like, oh shit, I ain't noticed. The club was here the whole time. I walked past this shit the whole time.
You know what I'm saying?
I never seen the door open. Never seen niggas going in. When you going, this shit packed.
That's crazy.
That's real shit.
Now, man. Another story, right? Now, another story. Jeff called me. No, I called Jeff one day.
This be fire, too.
That shit hard. I called Jeff one day. I go to the nigga crib. The nigga like, yo, that's Tiki Boom Brummer right there.
That's a fact.
And I was like, and shout I looked at the nigga Buddhist. And I said, nah, this nigga look just like Tick, like a little young.
Oh, little Bling. Shout out to Bling. Shout out to Bling, my little brother.
So I sat
Bling.
There, chopped it up.
He rap too.
Oh, he rap too?
Little Bling rap too.
Okay. So yeah, he was like, and I'm looking at him, he a little smaller than you, but I was
that's
like,
a fact.
I was
that's
like, nah, that nigga look just like Tick.
That's the
Tick,
twin.
My nigga.
That's my little twin.
So that's when I knew it was real. I was like, oh, nah, y'all fuck with each other. So now I came full circle. Now me, you, Jeff, we all know each other.
That's a fact.
And I was like, but Jeff, I never really. Like, I stayed away from him because he was doing big shit.
Yeah.
Like, Jeff was doing big shit, you know what I'm saying? Not crazy shit, but he was just doing big shit. And I was like, nah, I'm not on that level yet. Let me get my big dog shit.